My time as a church planter, or my experience in planting 5point7, it really is the culmination of my life's journey. It grew right out of my whole experience from childhood through my teenage years growing up in Detroit. Like so many of my friends, I grew up in a broken home. I grew up in a fatherless home, and I had a lot of time on my hands to get in trouble. But God intervened in my life. The Lord used my uncle, who was also a pastor in Detroit, to lead me to him and to begin the process of discipling me. And so the burden that led to me planting a church was I wanted to see my community transformed. I wanted to see families healed. I wanted to see children growing up with dads and moms in their homes. And I knew that it was the gospel that could do that. The gospel can restore, the gospel can redeem, the gospel can transform. It did it in my life. It can do it in this entire community. I had never thought through what it meant to plant a church. I had never thought through how to create a vision statement and a mission statement, how to develop a core team, how to fundraise and all of these things. I knew that I loved the Reformed faith and I wanted to teach it in my community. Eventually, God led me to meet a pastor at an EPC church downriver in Trenton, Michigan. Aaron was looking for someone in the inner city to help. And so it was God's providence that led us to each other. That's when we were connected with Scott McKee and the other churches in the Metro Detroit Church Planting Network. They found out about what we were doing and wanted to support us and help us in that mission. And that's where I was able to walk alongside other planters and pastors that I can learn from. Without that, this would have never become a reality. I don't necessarily fit the description of the typical Presbyterian pastor. And I think the EPC recognizes that in order to plant churches and to see the gospel reach new people, there needs to be a way to find space for those people who don't necessarily fit the conventional standards. Another thing I love so much about the EPC is bridging that gap between the inner city and the suburbs. It's special to me to see EPC churches coming down to volunteer and work in my neighborhood. That's one of the reasons that my relationship with Scott McKee and Ward is so special to me, because Ward Church has been one of those churches from the beginning. If you were to come to 5point7 on a typical Sunday, what you would see is a church that embodies community. The church is God's family, it's God's household. And so when you come to our church on a Sunday morning, you're gonna see little kids running all over the place. You're gonna see people whom God has blessed with some stability in their lives, and there's some economic stability there. But you're gonna also see people who are really having a hard time struggling to get a foundation. But the thing is that we love each other. We love each other. We don't push those people away, those who some would call the least and the last of society. We don't push them away, we love on them. And that's what you're gonna find. You're gonna find a church that doesn't just preach and doesn't just throw around religious terminology, but a church that tries to really demonstrate love through close involvement with each other. It doesn't just stop on Sunday. The church is my second home. Throughout the course of the week, I'm up there and I may get visits throughout the course of the day from people from the neighborhood. You know, everybody in the neighborhood calls me Pastor Brian. If I'm walking through the neighborhood, if I'm driving through the neighborhood, everywhere I go, people, Pastor Brian, hey, Pastor Brian. And I'm building trust that way. I believe what the community needs is love. These are real people with real hurts and with real pain. You know, it's not just community service and it's not just gospel centrality, it's both. Our goal is to take that 5.7 square miles, plant a church there in the center of that community, meet those social needs, but do it also preaching the true biblical gospel and showing the love of God in Christ. To be sent as a missionary to my community where I was born and raised, that's a privilege that I can't describe. There's no way to describe the joy that it gives me, because I feel like this is my people. I feel like this is my family. The thing that keeps resonating with me is if I don't share the love of Christ with them, then who will? So it's love, it's the love of Christ that compels me to continue in this great labor.